gibt an dieser Schule inzwischen eine Quasi-Tradition.
In the meantime, at this school, there's a quasi-tradition of big school journeys with the entire school community. The question has often been asked, why we undertake such trips at all, and there's certainly a whole bundle of reasons. There are also reasons not to. In favor, first of all, there is of course the community concept, the idea that a school community can learn and feel as a school community.
Wir wandeln auch auf den Spuren des Ordensgründers, wenn wir zum Beispiel
we also walk in the footsteps of the founder of the order when we're traveling in Greece, for example, because he was allowed to go on a journey as a youth, only a little older than our students. He was a law student back then and was also in Greece.
Tolles Erlebnis.
A great experience for all those involved. Afterwards, an entirely different mood was easily perceptible in a way I would never have expected it. Many students that greet you in a friendly manner anyway, whenever you meet them at school, greet you in a somewhat different way when encountered in Greece.
Wir sind in der Schule in Trägerschaft eines katholischen Ordens, der Herz Jesu.
We're a school sponsored by a Catholic order, the Sacred Heart Priests, who of course want to realize their special mission here, and actually do. Thus it's all related to the conception of man that we have. One can perhaps express it in this way in short form. The pedagogics precedes theology here. And that in the beginning there is awareness that each and every student entrusted to us, every male and female pupil, has been chosen by God, that he or she shares his or her story with God and the world, which we accompany to a certain extent. I always say this a little dramatically. We begin a common history when a student is here, but we don't want to shape someone according to specific interests, as it's often referred to nowadays.
For me, the spirituality of the Sacred Heart Priests is the basic idea Dion had, being close to the heart of Jesus, to see Jesus with the heart, and to spell it out over and over again. What does it mean here at school, this Sacred Heart adulation? Initially, it sounds like something from the 19th century, but one has to accept that. One has to find out what it means in concrete terms. How did Léon Dion live? What was important to him? And this is how we perceive it, to see with the heart of Jesus, to have an open heart. That means a heart that perceives yet is also vulnerable. Not hearts that have been made hard, but really vulnerable hearts. To heal the hearts of the students who are close to us, and to have a good mutual community.
The connection between the Sacred Heart Fathers and the school is, as far as I'm concerned, extremely good and very important for the school. The fathers are interested in what we do here, and especially those of us who sense the school pastoral, how we're supported and promoted. All of the projects we encourage, we can also implement, because it's a concern for the Sacred Heart Order that the school is characterized by Sacred Heart devotion.
I would like to see pupils from our school put into a position from which they could shape the world of tomorrow. It sounds a little dramatic, but it has a solid foundation. It doesn't have to be Christian. Of course, I'd prefer that, but they should experience it as something it's worthwhile to confront themselves with, to rub up against it as far as I'm concerned, to view the world without only seeing the world as material. But then again, we hope that students come here and encounter something, come into contact with something that plays a role also in their lives. But if we succeed, and I believe that here and there this is so, in arousing interest in one thing or another, that is to say, not just learning for the test, not just acquiring a degree with which one can realize something, rather that the things you do here are worthwhile engaging in. If this is so, we've already gained a lot.